Yo! It's the Hard For You podcast.
Back again.
My name is Juice English.
Saxon King.
This is episode 29.
29.
What's good?
Me, all right, you know.
You saying?
I'm all right. I got about a couple of weeks left of my prep for the first show. So, you know, man's just cruising.
Are you going to plug that? The show?
Just cruising.
You're going to plug it? Get the dates.
I don't care. As long as you take me there. Anyway, I ain't saying no dates.
Yeah.
Nah, you just find me. If people want to find me on social media, they'll find me. If they don't, they don't.
Just search the Saxon King.
If they hear my voice, if they want to see me in short, in like, you know, my trunks, you can find me. It's not about, you know, I ain't gotta plug it. If you want to do it, you do it. If you don't, ask. Cool.
Speaking of plugging, pause. Hard Food Podcast at Hard Food Podcast on Instagram.
Boom.
Search Hard Food Podcast on YouTube.
Boom.
Twitter, we're there. Facebook, we're there.
If you put us in Google, yeah, you'll find us.
I haven't done that. Is that work? On Google?
Of course it does.
I should do it. Yeah, I ain't done it yet still.
I ain't done it.
But yeah, man, what's good? I'm not even sure if it's been a busy week or a quiet week or what. There's been one main story in the week. And when my man talks, people, like, nothing else really happens.
But that's the thing.
And you see, Ja Rule was like, "Oh, yeah, I'm the most
not today. We got it.
Ja Rule was like, "Oh, I'm one of the most influential rappers ever." So I was like, "Ja, it's been a long day. Not today, please."
Not today. We got a lot going on.
Yeah, man, so let's just go straight into it, though. Yeah. Kanye West.
Here we go.
Kanye-zy.
Here we go.
The man himself, the genius, the GOAT, one of the GOATs. You get me?
He is, but you know. What I see is that...
Where do we start? Where do we tackle it?
I don't know where we start.
All right, let's tell them. Okay, so if you don't know, if you've been under a rock, basically Kanye West is back on Twitter.
Right.
And...
Last week he was good.
Yeah, I'm saying, I think last week he started tweeting...
It's the honeymoon period.
Positivity and, you know, a lot of talks of love, a lot of gems like, you know, self-worth and that kind of stuff.
Yeah,
and
man.
Then
yeah, man.
This week...
Yo.
I'm trying to think, where did it start? I think it...
Yo.
It basically said something like, I support Trump and the mob can't stop me from supporting Trump or whatever. And then he just posted more stuff to Trump. Trump tweeted him back saying, "Hey, Kanye, that's very cool. History in the making," all that kind of stuff. And then he posted a picture in the Make America Great Again hat. And, yeah, so everyone's just watching it thinking, what?
Let me just say something here. One thing that people have got to throw in the optics, yeah. When Eminem called out Trump, Trump didn't say nothing. Yeah.
Mm.
And Eminem blazed him. Yeah. Now, Kanye comes out and says he supports Trump, and then Trump jumps on the bandwagon.
I think the Eminem thing, I think
don't
it was
think,
a, that was
think,
obvious.
That's obvious. It's like when people thought, "Oh, why didn't Trump say anything?" Well, because Trump's like, "Yo, you ain't nothing to the people out there."
Well, that too as well. But I think Trump just knew Eminem was obviously trying to sell records off his name.
Yeah.
Like, either
Trump's
he knew
clever,
that.
You know.
Yeah, definitely.
People,
very clever.
People are not giving him the respect that he deserves because...
Wait, Trump?
He is? That's clever, you know.
Yeah, no, it's clever. I don't like respect, though. Respect's
no,
a bit...
No. People need to respect this man. The reason why I say that is because...
But he doesn't respect... Go on. Listen to this.
Listen to this. Think about this. Yeah. This guy, yeah, has pretty much used playground tactics, yeah, on the biggest scale on the planet, yeah. And my man's blagged his way into the White House.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That's the first thing. The second thing is that, yeah, he's done a little bit of, like, you know, politics. He's done a little bit. He's done small stuff.
Since being in the White House
before that.
Okay, yeah.
I looked him up.
Yeah, yeah.
I checked his, you know, the rap sheet.
Nothing successful, but yeah.
But he's been doing a bit. He's doing little bits here and there. So he knows, kind of knows what's going on. So, and this guy... has like, it must have been like a hobby because making money is his main job. So think about you having a hobby and becoming the best in the world, and it's just your hobby. That's what it's done.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Imagine you play football, yeah. You do your work, you work
here. Yeah.
You play football, five-a-side, then boom. Just playing five-a-side, and you blag your way. You're on the front cover of 4-4-2, yeah. You're playing for Chelsea, yeah. Banging goals in Chelsea in the league.
Mm-hmm.
You'd be quite chuffed, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, like, see, that's the thing. If we bring it back to Kanye now, yeah, that's the thing why I think Kanye's support... When he came out last year and said, oh, I would have voted for Trump, I support Trump. And I was looking at it in that sense, like, okay, what he's done is... never been done before, I don't think. You get me? He's not qualified to be president, but off his popularity alone and being real, he's become president, you get me?
Yeah.
And I thought that's what it was, like, Kanye was like, yeah, I'd support Trump, yeah. Because Kanye must relate to that, you get me? Must relate to being hated and loved as well, obviously, but hated and real, you know what I mean? So I saw real? It as... Who?
What is real?
Whatever you feel like, you don't pander your thoughts to make people happy, and Kanye doesn't do that. Trump doesn't do that.
Yeah,
obviously,
Trump doesn't do that.
Yeah, Kanye doesn't change how he thinks to make everyone else happy. Okay. Beyonce had the best video of the week. Of the year, you get me, single ladies.
Yeah, but that yeah, that's another story.
Yeah,
but I just think you see what it is. Okay, a few people may have seen me on Twitter. I was going off. Was it Wednesday or Thursday?
I think it was Wednesday, you know.
Wednesday, yeah. I was just, yo, popping off. And you know what? Every man is entitled to his opinion. And if Kanye wants to support Trump, it's his business, innit? Because you've got to get it that if he walks in the voting booth, regardless of who he is, he deserves to have the chance to make his vote. Yeah? Now... If you vote for Trump, vote for Trump. If you didn't, you didn't. It's not my problem. It's the Candace Owens thing that got my back up because
you knew who she was before he said it.
I saw one video of him before and I said, shut this foolishness off, man. Come off my phone.
Mm.
And then
explain because I still don't really know.
Okay, basically. She is a Republican. Yeah.
Mm.
And this is the thing, you know. Not all Republicans are racist.
Yeah? I think most of them aren't.
They're not racist. Not all of them are racist.
Oh, it's not based on racism anyway.
You know what I mean? It's just their ideas.
Mm.
Now, my point is that it's like Candace Owens is saying, black people need to stop playing this victim role and become a victor. Okay, I can agree.
Mm.
And then... the way she was playing the rest of the conversation, yeah, was like, drop the past, let it go, because it's not going to help you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, hold up. Put your foot on the brake. Take it off the accelerator, yeah? Because number one, my family, yeah, and I can say 80% of the black families in this country and America are in the position they're in financially due to the position they were put in due to slavery.
Mm.
Why? Because at the end of the day, one, you're taken from your home, which was Africa.
Mm.
Yeah. Once you are taken, you are brought to a foreign land, you don't know where you are, you don't know what your bearings are, and you are made to be a slave.
Yeah, I mean, we get that. We know that. Yeah. We know that. We should have known that.
So, boom. That's one thing. You're already below another person.
Mm.
Yeah? Another thing is, because you're under that person, that's the foundation, you know, fam. Mm. That's the foundation because, realistically... the knowledge that we can pass on to our kids, yeah, that builds their foundation to go further. Now, if we're behind the white man in society, yeah, then obviously you're going to feel a way to say, look, yeah, you don't need to stop this. Because we can sit here watching the amount of video. Honestly, you know what? I saw a video in the week and I know it got shared on social media, yeah. And yo, I wanted to send it to my friends, yeah? And I wanted to tag them in the video. But I was like, yo, I don't want to ruin your day, you know, fam.
Yeah.
Because did you see that video where the police officer was grabbing up that girl?
I heard about it. I don't watch videos.
Nah,
like
honestly,
that,
so. Yeah, it ruined my day.
Yeah, but someone told me about it. Like, yeah, have you seen that video?
And I was
like,
so you know,
nah, that's where like a breast came out. Yeah, the one. Yeah, and nah, someone told me about it.
It vexed me because I was like, yo, now I'm getting angry now just thinking about it. You know,
all right,
because,
okay.
Because and that's the thing. That she's acting, this Candace Owens is acting like these things aren't happening still.
No, but it's not.
These stereotypes are still happening.
So when
these
she's rolling. What's she saying? She's saying we should forget the past kind of thing.
Forget it.
But in what sense?
Oh, because it's not going to help you to a positive future. But,
there's a point to that, though.
There's a point.
No, what I'm saying, there's a point to forgetting it.
But at the end of the day, how can you know where you're going unless you know where you've been?
Yeah, but no, but that sounds like a different point. If she's saying forget the past, forget the whole slavery stuff, let's focus on moving forward.
Focus on moving forward. The white man shuts the door. No. What are you going to do? Oh, well, please, Mr. White Man, shuts the door on you again. No. I wonder why he's doing this to me. I really wonder why.
But why are we
Am I an idiot? No.
Why are we depending on the white man's approval?
Why?
So to say. Yeah.
Because at the end of the day,
the white man to open the doors.
Why? Because at the end of the day, the fact is that we haven't got the financial infrastructure to be building every single thing on our own. So obviously some things will have to go to the white man for it.
Yeah, but we know that, white people listening, but we know that the white man ain't here trying to help us, you get me? We know that.
Okay.
So what is dwelling on the past?
Yeah, so the fact is that if you know where you're coming from, yeah, you know what's out there. If I don't tell my child about slavery, when someone calls her end this, end that, am I wrong for not telling her? Because I've forgotten about the past.
Nah, I don't. See, that's extreme. I don't think...
It's not extreme, it's real life.
I've heard people say forget about the past before. I don't know about Candace Owens, but whenever someone said, forget about the past, let's focus on moving forward.
Jaw, you know.
I think there's a point to it because...
There isn't.
So what you think?
Maybe, no, why you shouldn't?
Why?
Because it makes you who you are.
What does slavery?
No, in a sense, yeah. This is what I'm saying. This is how I got to get deep now. The heart, yeah, and the strength that we have as black people is coming from the hardships, you know, fam.
Definitely.
We have come through some hard stuff, through centuries and centuries of slavery. Women raped, our strongest men killed in front of the others. Institutional racism, the way that the black man is put incarcerated unlawfully, yeah, the way we're treated in the police system, yo, it all boils down to the idea of saying, look, I'm better than you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah? You're lower than me. I owned you. Yeah? And because that filters through, fair enough, yeah, people don't own slaves. The mass population of American... The number, should I say, of American inmates being just pulled in for petty stuff, they're black men. It's ridiculous. I saw a video the other day, yeah, of a black man who was in DC. He was in prison for 45 years and unlawfully, and they came out and released him.
You know, there's so many stories like that.
You see what I'm
saying? There's so many stories like that.
And the man said he didn't have hate in his heart.
Yeah.
Now, there's another one.
Another one,
yeah.
There's so many that you could pull up.
But that's my point.
But then
we give it a blow, we ignore it. So why is it going to stop? It's not going to stop because we act like idiots, yeah, and say, I'll forget everything. We'll just move on out like it's not happening.
Nah, there's a difference. There's a difference between moving forward and ignoring it. Like I said, I don't know this Candace Owens chick, but when it comes to people saying forget about slavery, like, not saying we have to forget about slavery, but we can't dwell on that to move forward. We have to, like you said, we're black people, we come from hardship, and we've got that inner strength naturally. So really, truly, we should be putting that energy into excelling forward. Look at there's not obviously not as many as everyone else, but we've got rich black people that could be supporting the economy and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But a lot of the time, I don't know this as facts, but they might be more focused on spiting white people and buying their flashy stuff so I can look the part kind of thing.
Not all.
Rather than, no, that's not all, but you get some wealthy black guys that are more focused on buying stuff to look like the white people to prove that we're on their level. Instead of building up the whole community and raising us as a community, we got black people in positions to help communities, but
okay, answer me this now. Answer me this. Jewish people had reparation for
Yeah.
One black people got none.
But are we gonna get it?
No, but why?
No, but
now I don't know why.
Why do you think?
Why is it? Yeah, that the Jewish man was able to get reparation, and for all the black people, their families, whatever, put through slavery, their descendants now.
Who's getting it? Black people.
Yeah, the Windrush.
What is it? I was going to ask you about
even
that.
Even in America. Reparation.
Yeah.
Sending them back to Jamaica.
I was going to ask you about that.
Reparation. Yeah. How come the white man? Yeah. In theory, can give his money back to a white man, another white man, but he won't give the money back to a black man, even though he had him enslaved for like 400 years.
Okay, I ain't got an answer, but why? What do you have an answer?
There isn't an answer.
But I heard something. Wrong. I heard something over there. I forgot who it was. Wrong. No, I heard something over
it
there.
Should have been in the first place.
Who was it? It might have been Big U or something. I listened to some podcast. It might have been Big U on Randa. Anyway, someone said basically, Jewish people got reparation. All these other. Whatever, got reparations because they had the community, the kind of thingy to push for it. Black people, we don't have the voice for it. And obviously we got a loud vocal voice, but we don't have the infrastructure, we don't have the foundations that we could be, that we need something there to say.
Why don't we?
I don't know.
But why though?
But we know why we don't, but at the same time, Jewish people didn't when that happened to them. They didn't have it.
Who the people that own the banks in America?
So, basically, you think Jewish people, when they got the reparations, was it straight after?
I'm just saying. Who they do have the infrastructure to do that.
Who?
The Jewish community.
What? Did they straight after the Holocaust?
The Holocaust? No.
Something happened within that community. Jewish people supported other Jewish people to build up their community. So when you bring it to in front of, I'm going to say Congress, I don't know. When you bring it to the government, you have more of a leg to stand on. You know what I mean? At the moment, I don't know, like I said, I don't know this for a fact, but the government might be looking, thinking, okay, if we start giving black people reparations, where's it going to go to? If you give black people now £1 million each, what have we got in place to say that we're going to put that to good use?
But at the end of the day, the fact is, you don't know until you try.
No, but we live in a proactive society, isn't it? So we need to...
Yeah, but at the end of the day, you got to think about this. Okay, number one. People may say, oh, well, you can't give the black money to black people because they'll be fighting against each other for it anyway.
Mm.
Yeah. First of all, why is that mindset in place?
From the government?
No. Why is that mindset in place?
Black people, what mindset? Black people fighting each other?
Yeah.
We can't say it's all due to whatever happened.
No, but I'm just asking you, why?
Why is it?
No, I'm asking you.
I don't know.
Why does a black man look at another black man and hate him?
Why? You're gonna put that all down to slavery?
I'm not gonna drop no bars. I'm just saying it's all connected.
You think it's all connected?
There is a lot of trust me, yeah. There is do you read upon it?
I'm not even disagreeing with you, but if you read,
you can understand it. Okay, then answer me this now. Why would you? Even though we're going back to this, like we've said this all a while ago, yeah. Why would a Jamaican have beef with an African man?
No reason to have beef with an African man.
No reason, but the word wouldn't know. Do you see any other white man beef with another white man exactly the same that to that vehemently?
Yeah.
I don't.
But
on such a consistent basis. There is.
I mean, I don't know about white people, but Asians, there's an Indian and Pakistani. Is that all religion?
Yeah.
I don't know, but there's...
Who made that happen?
Huh?
Partition 1947 yes. In India.
Yeah. But what I'm saying is that's happened, but at the same time, they're still managing to rise with that in place.
It's different.
No, but we can't. No,
the reason why I say it's different.
I'm
not saying everything's to blame like on that. It's just because you got to realize it filters and changes. So when something
definitely,
filters,
100%.
It's like not the whole thing's going to get through, just a bit of it. And then a little bit's going to get more, a little bit more is going to get through and it's changed. And we're in a position that realistically, don't get me wrong here, I would say that, yeah, we do need to move forward. However, We can't forget slavery.
No, it's not a forget slavery. I don't think anyone... I don't, like I said, I don't know Candice Owens, but I don't think anyone's saying forget slavery.
The reason why I say that is because that pain, that hurt, that fire, you can use it as your fuel.
Yeah.
You get me? You can't forget it.
Yeah.
You can't act like it never happened.
No one should be saying forget slavery. We should be using that.
No one's sitting there and saying... I ain't saying... I'd never say forget it because the fact is that... That's part of my history, my culture, that I can say, yo, we're strong, you know.
Yeah, but that's what I said.
And then I use it as fuel to say, yo, I could go out there and I can do what I need to do. However, I know what is out there waiting for me.
Mm.
And if I did not tell my children what is out there waiting for them, I'm a bad parent.
Like I said, though, if we as black people start investing in black people, when we start bringing the case of reparations to the people that have the money, we've got more of a leg to stand on.
Reparation will never happen now because the whole world's broke.
Well, yeah.
The whole world's broke to itself.
Yeah, but we need, like I said, we need a better leg to stand on. We need some sort of black... What's we need a black bank?
Had them?
Well, yeah, they had it and they got teared down.
They got bombed out by... Who was he?
I don't know.
Some white supremacists, basically, they had black bands, black everything, and they bombed it out.
But like you said...
But they don't class that as a mass killing in American history.
Yeah.
You get me? They always talk about, what was he? Honestly, if you do your research, there was a part of America that had black banks.
Black Wall Street.
That had black everything, And it got bombed out.
Mm-hmm.
And... it's like they tried to wipe it clean from the history books, like it never happened.
But like we said, we already know black people are strong enough to move to
mountains.
Move forward with all that happening. So let's just continue to do that.
Yeah, I'll bond the pagans anyway. Anyway,
back to Kanye. So is that what? Because I've been trying to figure out what he's done wrong.
For me. That's what I didn't
Was it that?
It's like, I like a way of thinking and da-da-da. I'm like, come on, man.
I think he's keeping it vague for a reason to get that emotion from you. When you were saying that, I was saying, I just want to hear him do a spoken interview because there's no way he can just say, I like the way Candace Owens thinks and Charlamagne just going to be like, okay. Charlamagne's going to be like, why? What do you like about Candace Owens? Why are you supporting Trump? You know what I mean? At the moment, he's just putting out his 140 characters or whatever, and he's not being challenged on it. He's not answering anyone's questions. He's just putting out his thoughts. So when he didn't even really answer the Ebro's questions.
Kinda.
The only thing I've seen him like answer was when Kim said, when Kim phoned him and he had to clear up what he said. And he says, I don't like everything Trump does, but I support this guy so much and I love him. And it's like, but you still haven't told us why you love him, you get me? You can't just come out and say, I Kanye West black man, George Bush doesn't like black people, but I love Donald Trump. And not tell us why you love him. You get me?
Not the same person.
So it's keeping it vague.
Not the same person, fam.
But then, like I said to you, it's kind of weird that everyone that's spoken to him and everyone that's gone to visit him or whatever are saying he's in a good place, his head's in a good place and whatever. There's more to these tweets. Like I said, he's keeping it vague for a reason. And until he does a spoken interview, and if he doesn't, until I hear the music and see... I need a better idea. I can't just judge him completely from the tweets. Like I said, the tweets have put Kanye West into question for me right now.
Question.
Yeah, but like I said to you as well, I've got time for Kanye. Mm. I've got time.
I normally would, but it's like, you know what? There's certain like ways to go about things as well. If I do something, and I'm tripping, and you message me and say, yo, Adrian, chill, man. And then I put your message, your messages, boom, on Twitter, like you did to John Legend.
Yeah.
I'm like, you got no manners.
I know.
You got no manners. Because really, you're hollering me.
So what?
Is your boy.
Yeah, I call this, sir.
You get me? You're hollering me as your boy to say, yo, fam. Yo.
Yeah.
Even talk to me, say, what's going on, Wagwan? You know what I mean? Mm. And then if I go and just switch on you and just put you on blast like that, nah, man, nah. I know people might think, yeah, but that's funny. But if that was me, I'd be like, all right, cool.
Yeah, but okay, let's say this then. isn't Kanye West's mental health issues, isn't it?
Who says it? Who's...
He cancelled the tour for mental health reasons. Like, he cancelled his tour. He did two performances, walked off stage after 18 minutes and cancelled the rest of the tour.
Yeah, but the thing is, you know what?
And just because it's Kanye West and is involved in the Kardashians, we're going to say, no, he's not really mentally ill. No, he's not. Like...
No, but the thing is, you know what I'm thinking, yeah? What I'm thinking is, part of me thinks, not all, but part.
Mm.
Part of me thinks people change.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm. Now, no, people do change. Yeah.
Because people change. Yeah. How do we know that Kanye is just like pretty much? He's just literally as a different in a different space. He is a different person.
We don't know.
We don't know, but it's like his music would show us that he's a different person.
Mm.
Yeah. His music would say people would say, yeah, but he's evolved. Okay, so he's changed.
Mm.
Yeah. Now, if his music's changed and he's changed, how do we know he thinks the same as he did when he made College Dropout?
No, we don't.
We don't
we
know.
We don't know.
So the fact is, if he's sitting there saying, I love Trump, he might actually love Trump.
And but that's what I'm saying. I want, I want a spoken interview.
He might actually sit there and be able to say, well, I like Trump. You can't stop me from liking him.
Yeah.
You might disagree, but, you know, can't do nothing.
And
so I'll wear my MAGA hat and laugh at you all because I'm rich.
Yeah.
And you're not.
But like I said... I got time for if Kodak Black said yeah, I support Trump,
unfollow
Black. I don't want to know. But Kanye West was it. I'm like, you know, let me hear what he's got to say. Let me hear because Kanye West, like I said, I got time for.
Why'd you give him time though?
Yo, it's Kanye West has been a big part of my life.
So
what?
So people don't do you wrong.
Yeah, what's it? Okay, that's another thing. Then, so what has Kanye West done wrong?
You know what it is. There's some people that dislike the idea they like Trump. I don't care. Me personally, I couldn't care less.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I thought that's what it was.
I don't care.
Freedom of choice. If he supports Trump, he should be able to support Trump.
He supports Trump. If he does, he does. If he doesn't, he doesn't.
Mm.
Yeah? Now, my point is that as a person that has made so much money from a certain...
Oh, pardon me, sorry.
Like... audience, yeah. You kind of, it's like you kind of like you like it's like you're whining and dining them, yeah.
Yeah.
And they're under a spell. And because they're under your spell, because they like you that much, you can pretty much do anything you want, and they'll forgive you. And that's what he's doing. Now, I'm like, nah, bruv. If it don't make sense, if it looks a bit funny, if it looks a bit off key, yeah. I'm going to say something. I'm not going to just let it pass because how do I know? You're just not mugging me off.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's the reason why when people sit there and say, oh, well, why are you calling out Kanye? Da, 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 da. Well, I've got... if I've, like, you know, I've paid money to see him in concert.
Mm.
Yeah? So he's had some of my hard-earned money. Yeah? Now, because of that... It's like, am I supposed to, if there's something that I completely disagree with or find a bit questionable, maybe just say, oh, it's all right, it's him. So
yeah.
I go with it too.
Yeah. No, that's not what's being done, though.
I'm not a mug, but that's how some people think it is.
Yeah.
And the thing is, you know what, as well? Okay, I thought about this in the week. The reason why, yeah, I don't want to bring him up again. If I sat there and I said, Nah, it's cool, it's Kanye. Nah, I might give him a blow. He's gone on some foolishness, but he's all right. Yeah, the music's good. Then I'll be a complete hypocrite for my views on Tekashi.
Yeah.
You see what I mean?
Yeah.
So I've got to keep the same energy.
Mm.
And I have kept the same energy because I haven't called Kanye a knob, though.
So don't you believe that Kanye...
I haven't called Kanye a knob.
Don't you believe that Kanye deserves a bit more... I can say time. Don't you think Kanye deserves a bit more time than Tekashi 6ix9ine? For what Kanye's done on his resume.
I do agree he does deserve a bit more time just due to loyalty.
Mm. And mental health issues.
How do we know 100% he's mentally ill?
We don't know anything 100%.
That's my point.
But if
don't know.
If he's cancelled his tour for mental health issues.
Criminal exhaustion.
Mental health, like if we've cancelled his tour for mental health issues, he's hit on songs that is on drugs for the mental health promethazine or whatever. No, that's two chains. It's said that he's on his drugs. And as an artist, I wouldn't be surprised if when it comes time to working on an album, it comes off the medication, so he's, you know, he's on edge. You know what I mean?
Edging fall off.
You know what? Even he probably does fall off, because even that, to me, it seems like someone that's relapsing. There was one guy now, I used to always see him on Broad Street, and it'd be like, tall guy. Not him. There's one light-skinned guy. I used to always see him on Broad Street now, And, like, he used to have his hair in afro or whatever. You see him, normal. Oh, what's good? Yeah, bless you. Yeah, I've seen you in a long time, whatever. Just give it a couple of weeks, he starts getting a bit more weird. You start seeing him hanging around a bit more, to a point where, like, a month later, he's lost it. You know what I mean? He's doing weird stuff. And then people say, because what happens is, when you're checked into wherever you are for mental health, they put you on the drugs, innit? Stabilizer. But then, eventually, you've got to come off them. So when you come off the drugs, Cat Williams the same. He said it as well. Like, when you come off the drugs, they put you back into society, and, you know, life is life. You get me? So you come back out, you start relapsing. You say, like I said, because Kanye came back on Twitter last week and it was all normal, and then was it Wednesday, whatever? It just seemed like it blew up. Thursday was no better. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, it just seems like it's relapsing. I wouldn't be surprised now if he drops the album, goes back into hiding, gets back on his drugs, and it's just quiet Kanye again. He's definitely on some sort of drug. He's not the same guy. There's something
but
there.
You got to look at it. What has caused that?
It's trauma.
From what?
Car crash through the wire. Okay. Mum died 2008. Okay. Hated by the world 2009.
Why?
Not letting into the fashion. What? Hated by the world?
Yeah.
Because he said Beyonce's video was better than Taylor Swift's while he was drunk on stage.
I wouldn't say it was hated.
Oh my god, the president called him a jackass on TV. You get me? Obama. So the first black president. And you know what I mean? And he doesn't like you. You get me? Fashion world won't let you in. You get me? They're trying to marginalize you. You should just be a rapper. You get me? Kanye West, his wife was frigging 2 years ago, was tied up in a bathtub and robbed in France. You get me? The man's
was
like.
Was that your posting nudes?
Eh? That's her. So you said. I ain't even gonna get into that.
The man's life's full of trauma.
The man's life's full of trauma. Jay-Z, someone
that means he needs to delete his Twitter account.
He did, and then he comes back, and then he's like,
delete it and dash it where?
He comes back. Album time, he's got to do promo, free promo. This is free promo for him. You get me? His budget is
millions, not £2.
His budget is zero. No, he's doing it all on Twitter. Kanye, June 1st, me and Kid Cudi June 8th. Now everyone's buzzing for all that. That's the kind of promotion you pay money for. Yeah,
part of me might not even listen to the Kanye album. All I'm saying is, do not mess up Pusha and do not mess up Nas. Because you mess up them too, you know, I will never, ever, ever, ever forgive you.
I mean, Kanye produced What My Name Is My Name. Amazing album from Pusha T. So, if the music's still good. Okay, that's if the music's good, do we uncancel Kanye? No. I know you don't.
No. Because you know what? As I said, man, because if he comes out in his album and he talks some messed up, weird bars, talking about Trump and blah, 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 and it filters into the music... I'm like, fam.
Yeah, I'm hoping it doesn't.
I'm not feeling it, because that means, it's like... Art mirrors life. Yeah. Mm. It does mirror real life. And the same way that 444 does mirror Jay's life, the same way that KLD, like, it's a retrospective look at the world we live in of real life now, from J. Cole's perspective, yeah.
Yeah.
Yo.
But those guys... Go on.
What is going to be in Kanye's mind to put out on Wax? Well, not Wax, but, you know, MP3.
I mean, Kanye's a
or
different...
MP4A.
Kanye's a different kind of artist.
Or Spotify.
Where Jay-Z...
Big up iTunes.
Where Jay-Z will come and tell you what happened in his life.
Yeah.
And J. Cole, the very direct artist. I tweeted in a week, I said that J. Cole and Kanye West are like total opposites.
Yeah, they are.
And it's like, J. Cole is very direct. Here's my message. You know what I mean? This is, you know what I mean? Kendrick Lamar, Kanye West, they kind of put their... life and that into stories, and it's all in the art.
Yeah, but the thing is, you know what?
Did you see that? Did you see that Kanye film where he's freaking having sex with a phoenix, that Big Bird? Come on, you had to see that 2010 Runaway film.
No, I didn't watch it.
Yeah, for the My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy
album. What you're on about.
You didn't watch it?
I didn't watch it.
I watch that regularly, you know. Sick. It's sick. Nah, the colours and that, he's a very good colour palette for it. But, yeah.
But, my point is that if the music starts, like, mirroring all this, I'm like, yo, fam.
I hope so.
You need to calm yourself because it's... I don't know, man. People, I know people are going to feel betrayed.
Yes.
They do feel it. But I'm just like, yo, you know what? He's a person. And the same way I can get him out of here with, like, I can get out of Tekashi and I can just, like, the same way I can do to Kanye West. People might say, yeah, well, but didn't you like him a lot? Yeah, I did.
Yeah. I mean, I'm emotionally attached to his music. You get me?
Like,
that actually hurt. Like, what was it, Wednesday? I ain't going to lie. Like, you might think I'm being dramatic, but I felt weird. Just knowing that Kanye West was going on like that, I felt weird. I was like, nah.
I feel weird. You know why?
I was like, nah, this ain't happening.
Do you know why? Do you know why? Do you know why? Because there's been a few things that I've looked at Kanye and I've been like, yo, fam, you need to sort your head out.
Yeah, but...
And you know what it is as well? I'm like, yo, first of all, people might say, oh, well, Kim's doing what Kim does. But, yo, you got 3 kids now.
Mm-hmm.
And... the last thing your child wants to see when they're 18 is nudes of your mum when your dad's having a bad time. Yeah?
Yeah.
That's the last thing. Because I noticed that Kanye had his little fallout and then Kim put out some pictures she took in the bathroom while we're on the bed. And it's for like that, the world...
Was it fragrance or something?
I don't know what it was. But the world said, we're bored of your pictures.
Mm.
Keep them. Now... 10 years ago, people were like, yo, you seen the Kim K pics? But now it's like, we've seen your body a million times. That means your body is worth less to us.
Mm.
Worth less. If someone said, oh, here's a picture of Beyonce in, I don't know, some topless picture of Beyonce, the amount of people that would download it, the internet would break. But because Beyonce doesn't carry herself like that. Beyonce carries herself like a queen. Kim carries herself like trash. Now...
Nah, I wouldn't say trash.
I would say trash because the fact is, yeah, trash is thrown out on a Tuesday.
Mm.
Gets picked up by the bin men. Big up to the bin men. Need you. Love you. But the fact is, anybody can see it. Everybody can see it. You keep your queen at home. You protect your queen.
Mm.
Yeah? Your queen, like Jay-Z and Beyonce, yeah, they have... shown what, yeah, it's like people might say, you know, when people say power couple. I'm gonna go on something else as well, but let me just finish this point. When they say power couple, it's a case that, yo, I respect you in the same way you respect me, yeah.
Mm.
So I respect my wife to say, ah, oh, cool, I don't speak to you a certain way, so you don't speak to me that way. You get me? So Kanye's pictures. Of Kim's pictures out there, as a husband, I'm like, yo, can you just calm with that?
Kanye might like that. I think Kanye does like that.
But I think it's just nah. Just but that shows that makes your wife accessible.
Does people we can't? Yes, one thing.
It makes it accessible.
One thing I think I noticed that you do, you can't expect everyone to think on your level.
No.
And you do that.
I do.
Everyone doesn't think on your level.
Because I think, yeah, I'm like, yo. You got to think like prestige. Because one of carry yourself a certain way.
Yeah, one of the reasons why I come across as so accepting of everything is because I just realized like everyone is different.
Mm.
Everyone is different, and as long as it doesn't affect me and my life and how I think, just left them to it. Like
you know what it is.
That's Kanye's wife,
you know,
and Kanye. And
you know what it is. You know what it is.
That's like, what they like to do.
I'm like the type of person to think, yo. Okay, if you're going to be different, but don't come moaning to me when you come tell me about something, and you did this, and this person did this because of you doing such and such. Well, really, it's like if someone's on the gram showing chains off, whatever, and they get robbed. Well, obviously, you dummy, you're going to get robbed because you've been showing everyone your chain, haven't you? You fool.
Mm.
Now, if you just keep it to yourself, you mind your own business, act like a normal human being on the planet, then no one would rob you.
All right, cool. To move it from Kanye, well, last point on Kanye then.
Yo, don't mess up the Nas album.
I was going to say, Kanye's producing for Nas.
Me and you.
And Nas, people say, has got like the worst beat selection ever. So Nas, no one can question Nas's lyrical ability.
Nah, I don't care.
Is this album about to sound fire with Kanye production? Because Kanye production doesn't even mean Kanye production. Just mean, no. I think he's executive producing it. So Kanye is sound.
I'm expecting like Jay-Z epic proportions, like super duper production on it.
Yeah,
that's what I'm expecting. Very produced well. I'm very very well produced, should I say, and very like attention to detail in a lot of ways because we know. Yeah. How Nas is as an artist.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And Kanye, that's what Kanye's like when it comes to production.
Like anyway.
And you know, I've noticed Nas is on a lot of, quite a few Rick Ross beats.
Yes.
And it fits in well. That whole glamorous kind of grandiose soul production behind Nas works well, so I'm expecting that as well.
I want to hear Rick Ross in this album.
June. What, on Nas's album?
Yeah.
Should do.
I'd love to hear Rick Ross.
Because them two work together quite a lot.
Rick Ross and Nas work very well.
Yeah.
And to be fair, watching that rap, watch that Rapture. People watch that.
Yeah,
Rapture.
I don't know why I haven't watched it. I don't even know why
Dave East and Nas, man. It's like, it gives you a little intro to like who Dave East is, obviously, and like what he's an artist. And it kind of like, you delve into the mind of Nas. And people, don't get me wrong, yeah, these kids nowadays don't appreciate Nas, you know.
Nah.
Don't appreciate him. Mm-mm. He has a boss, man. He's a boss.
Alright, and so now we've lived with the J. Cole album.
Yeah.
Any differing thoughts?
I like it even more.
You like it more? You know what?
But that's me. Because I'm the type of person, how can I put it? People think I'm grumpy, because I see a bag of stupidness in the world. You get me? From the people I work with. Yeah, the stupidity they come out with. And I think, are you that stupid? To the things I see on television, like me going out last night.
We didn't talk about it.
I didn't talk about it. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's segue into this going out last night. So, it was my boy's birthday, I went to 101, in Birmingham. Now, don't get me wrong. You know, it's a nice venue, nice room and that, lots of space and ting. But you can't blame the club because it's not their fault. But I'm just like, the way people move nowadays is so different. The mobile phone has mashed up everything.
Fully, completely.
Mashed up everything. It's like you had, this is what here we are. I'm standing there, with two of my compadres. One with a Brook foot, and the foot's not Brook now.
I was gonna say the foot not Brook no more.
big up, heel foot, heel up foot with the plaster, and my bread drinking, and we're standing there now because it wasn't as like rammed, and there's about 8 or 9 guys like in a booth thing there.
You lot all
no, we're just standing on the floor, just listening to the music and whatever, and these guys They got like between 9 of them, there's about 3 bottles of champers. I'm looking at them thinking, these guys are giving it the most, But they've got no girl. You man, acting like you are balling in a music video. There's no girl up in there. So really, it's just like a massive sausage fest. With champers. And I'm like, and then one of them got the champers and sprayed it all over them. I'm like, you're an idiot.
All over who? The man
after
them?
After the rest of the man them.
You don't spray man them with
exactly.
Champagne.
Exactly.
Champagne shower the man them. Nah, blood. You went to do it over the... That's not it. You ain't doing it right, man. It's
awesome. I looked at him. I was looking, thinking, there's something wrong with this, there's so much wrong that I can see right now.
So, is in 101, there's loads of girls in 101, isn't it?
Yeah, there's bare.
So why weren't on the...
I don't know. Because they couldn't get... I looked at... You know what? I'm not going to lie. Don't get me wrong here. I'm not saying I'm no Tyson Beckford.
Get me.
Tyson Beckford.
Get me. I'm not saying I'm no Tyson Beckford, but yeah. And I'm out the game.
Yeah.
I'm out of that game, like out. I signed out years ago. Straight and narrow guy. Kids and that. But obviously, man's just, you know, just fresh trim. All tight, Danny. Yeah.
All tight.
And fresh trim. You know, shout myself. I'm just looking like, looking kind of suave in the shirt and that. And obviously, get a look in. I mean, now, if I wanted to entertain convo, the possibility's there.
Of course.
Now, these nine suckers in there, yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty much like playing with the lightsabers and swinging them, hitting each other.
What lightsabers?
They're dicks.
Oh, okay.
You get me?
You know what, though? Like...
And I'm like, yo, you, man, yeah. And I'm looking at each one of them, you know, I'm like, no game, no game,
well,
no game, no game.
Okay, right there.
Zero game.
So there was nine, man, with all in the booth, like, sitting down.
Nah, they were just all jumping all over each other.
Nah, see, what you got to do here... I said to wife, I said, oh, like, when you go out now, yeah, you want girls in the booth. You don't need to be moving to anything, you know, but the booth looks better.
It looks better.
With girls in the booth.
It looks better. Even if some girls just talking between themselves, it's just like, yo, having a nice
like, not every girl you have nice to vibe. Try to ting with, you know, like, literally, if you're in the booth. Like,
sometimes you can, if you're in a booth, you can say, oh, do you want, you and your friends want to come sit in here? It's cool, whatever.
Hold two drinks.
If you want a couple drinks, have a drink. We're not trying to just enjoy the night, innit?
Exactly.
Because you've got the space. And I'm just like, yo, these idiot, man. I just don't get it. I'm sitting,
that's what I'm going to say. So if you got nine man in the booth, you got to send three of them out into the dance floor and start scouting.
Draw them in,
innit? You say, yo, yeah, we got the booth over here. Come here. You don't just sit in the booth.
You're using it wrong.
Yeah. You meant to have the booth there to make people, to make the girls feel safe.
That's insane.
Yo, I got booth over here. Still come. Yeah, you want to drink?
When you see the one man, that just won't leave the girl alone. This is like, yo, fam, yo, just leave her, man, leave her. Nah, she wants to talk to me. Yo, you're the geezer, when he turns his back, you walk over, you scoop up, you say, I'll come to the booth, man, I'll leave you alone.
That's the thing, like, the joke is now, I don't even talk to girls when I'm out. Like, you don't need to talk to the girls, as long as the girls are close, you don't need to talk to them. It's like, it's optics. You get me, like, it just looks better.
It looks better.
Fam, nobody, not like, even like, in a relationship, single, whatever. Nobody wants to go out and see bear man anywhere. You don't want to go anywhere. You don't have a booth. If you got a booth here and there's nine here, you don't get a booth that seats nine.
No,
you get
a booth
that seats 14.
Yes,
and you just like
just out, man.
It just don't make sense. I can't believe that nine man in a booth.
And the thing is, you know what? The joke is, when I was in there now, it's like I can explain it. It's like. It's the first time I've been there. Yeah. And the startenders, is that what they're called? The bartender, them chicks that bring all the bottles and that.
Yeah.
It's like...
Actually, I think that's actually your name. But go on. 101 girls.
And the thing is now, they're there now. And in my opinion, I get it. I'm trying to be more of America. Spock, don't put 101 girls in there.
Nah, put 101. Yeah, 101 nightclub.
Do you want to see the roster? First draft pick. That one. But it's like, they're there now. And to be fair, it's like, all for the gram. When the bottles come out. When the bottles come out, no one looks at the person it's going to be at. It's like, everyone's got, it's like, bottles come out. Take out the phone. And I'm like, you're missing the element of actually being out. It's like you're out to tell everyone you're out. You're not out to enjoy yourself.
I mean, you know what though? like you said, the phone has matched up everything, but it's not even the phone. Like, literally, everyone now has a camera in their pocket.
Yes.
It's a camera. And, like, growing up, before you could go to the clubs, you look at the music videos, you look at whatever they were doing, and you're like, yo. So, obviously, you go out, and it looks nice when you're out, but when you do the video looks even nicer, because it's like, 10 seconds of joy. Mm. You get me? So, that's why everyone's just looking for that clip, that 10 seconds, just to show everyone, yo, I look like I'm in a music video.
Yeah.
You get me?
I think it's just mash up the thing, man, and people don't. I think as a DJ as well. If as a DJ, I think Lucas Dirty spoke about this. I'll talk Lucas.
Mm.
He said because the phone is there, it's like the vibe isn't the same.
Because everyone's
on their phone instead of enjoying the music. When you go out, you're supposed to enjoy the music, and it's like, yo, calm, man. Because
even that, yo,
you're missing. It's like you're missing moments.
Yeah.
You're missing memories because you're on your phone. And realistically, the ability of description and the depth of description that people do nowadays must have dropped, because it's like, oh, how was it? Look.
Yeah.
Nah, tell me what happened. No. Look. And then just throw the phone in your face.
Even yo, I remember now, saying to, this is time ago, saying to my brethren, yo, I go out for the music, you know.
Mm.
And man, they started laughing. So you go out for the music, but for the girl. I was like, nah, it's not even about the girl.
I go out for the music, man.
So for the music.
Honestly, I'm not going to lie. When Usman went out, when House was at its highest, I did not. Yo, it was just music. Even when we went out to Miami, when we went out when we were younger, even going out early, just going out for the music, man, because at the end of the day, I don't care. Me having a good time does not depend on me talking to ex-gal, this gal, that gal, because, yo, realistically, I don't care. You ain't nothing to me.
Yeah, exactly.
The second you're talking to me, I tell him about you. Can we talk to that geezer over there? Yeah, ain't nothing to me. Fix up.
Big up to 101, because obviously there's a gap in the market. Like,
yo, they're making peas.
I ain't gonna lie, I do want to go there for that.
They're making peas.
I do want to go there.
Every man's out. Yo, lads. You're going 101, yeah? Try and be original, please. Every man in the lubes, Balenciagas, Giuseppes. Yeah, you all look like a carbon copy of each other. You know what I mean? I went there in a shirt, get me? People might say, yeah, but you're grown, innit? Yeah, but obviously...
Oh, but man went wearing shirts?
Fam. Man went wearing jumpers, T-shirts, hoodies.
Nah, don't say hoodies.
Caps? Because they were designer.
Nah, yo, I tried to go there for my birthday, just chatting about, I was chatting to someone, I was DMing their account. Mm. I was like, oh, what about this? Can I get in with this? What's the dress code like? It's like, oh, nah, not that. It's really formal. I was like, okay, nah, I'll go there next time. I went, nah, Bambi, man, had a great time.
It was
time.
A case that, yo, any trainers, yeah, that's I think it was supportive of any trainers along the designer.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And I'm
like,
come on, man. Make it, it's like, if you want to make it a prestige, like, you know, venue, you got to step it up.
Mm.
You got to, like, really say, look, man, you ain't wearing that to come in. That's why I just think that's why some people say it's the roadman's paradise.
Drug dealer's dream. Speaking of dreams and nightmares.
Big up. Good segue still. Big up.
Yeah.
Yo. Yeah, I want to hear some 1942 flows, man.
Mix home.
Yo. Big up. Man was happy, you know.
Yeah, I'm happy for me, still.
Flows.
It's coming. But,
so, yeah, I do.
I don't know how should I let this run.
Only 1942 flows, man.
No, it's coming.
But, yeah. So, Meek's home.
Meek Mill's home.
And I was happy, you know. I can't believe how happy I was, though.
Yeah.
It shocked me. You know when at first you think you don't care? But because it builds up for so long and you see so much of this evidence in the story and this the judge did this and they did this wrong and they did that wrong and they shouldn't have done this. I'm just like, yo, part of you gets emotionally attached to it. I'm like, yo, my man shouldn't be in prison. End of story.
Mm.
He shouldn't. It's like, if you're going to give him a slap on the wrist, give him a slap on the wrist. But yo, you don't need to find prison for 2 to 4 years. I'm really, nah, come on, man. And the judge business.
I didn't realise how long this was, you know.
It was long, you know.
I didn't even realise.
It is long. That's what I'm saying. This is the part that Juice is waiting for.
Here
we go.
Juice!
No.
Anyway.
Yeah, my tune, you know.
I'm just... It's a
Hard. But yeah, what do you think?
You know what? I didn't really think too much about it. Obviously, I'm happy that a man's free. Cause I'm just happy, like, you should be happy a man's free anyway. I didn't really think about it too much until I listened to the Talk Dirty podcast. Have you listened to it?
This week's.
Yeah. And, like, I that was a really good episode still. Hold tight, Myers and Kay. Yeah, that was it was a good episode. It was a good episode this week still. Because I felt like the man are, like, getting back into the groove of just talking kind of thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It was an interview, just literally catching up. But, yeah, they had some good points in there still. Basically, Lucas was saying it feels like everyone's being fake about... Like, why is everyone so happy Meek's home and that kind of stuff when 2 years ago it was, oh, is that a world tour or your girls tour? You get me? So...
You know what it is? On that, for me, on that point, it's like, yo, Meek knows he was moving funny. And he came out and said, yo, I wasn't moving right, you know, because I was using drugs that I shouldn't have been using. And I was in an environment that wasn't conducive to my progress. And being around Nicki wasn't helping him, so... People are going to climb in this. This is the nature of the beast. And no one doubted Meek's ability. It's just that compared to the hard Meek Mill that we know, it's like it went soft. So people might say, ah. I know my boys like saying, ah, people might be fake. Some aren't fake. I've liked Meek regardless. I've got all his albums and I've got his mixtapes. But some people, that's just the nature of the beast because... The way that the public eye is so close to everything that people do.
Yeah, you know what it is for me? See, that's the thing. I've never really been a massive Meek fan anyway. For me, Meek's always had, like, a couple songs that I like.
Nah, man.
But I can't listen to too much Meek because it's always shouted. It just, like, it used to shout all the time. And then it was only until Dreams Worth More Than Money where he kind of had the humble moments. Yeah. Not humble, but, like, you know, more calm moments. And then all that happened with Drake. And I said, oh, Meek Mill's out of here. I said, oh, I think I said it on here as well. I said, oh, Meek Mill ain't coming back kind of thing. I said, it all depends. If he drops good music, then it's coming back. And then he dropped Dream Chasers 4. And I said, it's good. But I don't think it's good enough to save his career. Like, not to say that he's going to have a bad career now, but to get... I thought, like I said, I didn't think he was amazing or anything. But I thought, okay, Meek Mill's going to hit that top five. You know what I mean? J. Cole, Drake, whatever. Meek Mill's going to be in there. It's only until wins and losses, I said, yo, Meek Mill's going to be back in there. You get me? Like, Meek Mill is going to be... He's going to start making his claim again for that top five, maybe for even top three. But, sorry, was it? But then he got locked up.
Yeah.
And it was like, I was saying, like, 2 to 4 years, that's hard because the momentum's just starting to roll again for him. Like, obviously, the Drake thing was a big dip in his momentum. Now, momentum's starting to roll, then it gets locked up. But whoever was in charge of the PR, the whole Free Meek campaign, that was doing a great job. But
they need a big pat on the back.
But I was just wondering, I said, can you really do that for 2 to 4 years? Can you get that? But now he's, like, was it 5 months he was locked up for?
Yeah.
Like, say, perfect. You know what I mean? Obviously, it's not great being locked up or anything, but it's that little stint in prison is going to do amazing things for me.
Yes, it will. Because they'll say, oh, he served that much time in prison already.
Yeah. Oh, I'm not even talking about that. I'm still talking about for the music.
Oh, no. I'm talking about his prison sentence.
Yeah,
at the end of the day, if they sit there and say, oh, he's already served 5 months and you had him there unlawfully, they can say, oh, well, okay then. If we knock it down, then... We might be able to just take it down to a fine and blah, blah.
Yeah, I mean, I've never really deeped it on that side of things, you know. Man. I've never really deeped the legal side of it. Judicial side of it. That's all, folks. But yeah, I've never really looked at that side of things too tough. So I've always looked at it for the music. And like I said, wins and losses showed a different side of Meek. And he was rapping slowly, more mature. That's the best word. Basically, Meek Mill matured. And I'm really, really, really looking forward to seeing what it comes. And yes, what it comes with now. And yes, I was one of the guys, when he was getting burnt by Drake, I was Team Drake. I was like, yeah, it's at your girls' tour, right? You know what I mean? I was that guy. Getting bodied by a singer. I was that guy. But I'm really looking forward to what Meek Mill comes next. And I don't really think that makes me or anyone else fake, because...
You're fake.
No, because look at what... I don't know.
Fake love.
I feel like if you look at how he's matured as an artist... If you look at how he's matured as an artist, I feel like it's kind of hard to still... Like you said at the start of this whole conversation, it's a new Meek.
Mm.
It's a more mature Meek, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what he comes out with now.
I've liked him for a long time, man.
Mm-hmm.
I think because I was listening to Maybach music for a long while, and I'm a boss. Obviously, it got me hyped.
Yeah.
Then...
You know, no one talks about Tupac back.
Yeah,
You know, I knew it if you can find it, because that tune there.
But anyway, as he's looking for the song, I think that realistically, even though he did take the L with Drake, he took it. He's like, yo, I took it on the chin and just got to move forward in it. And I think as well, the influence of Jay.
Yeah.
Because he's now on Roc Nation.
Yeah, he's been on there for a while though. He has been on there for a while.
His wins and losses on Roc Nation, because I looked and it's on MMG Atlantic.
No. It's not signed to Roc Nation. It's managed by Roc Nation. Yeah. I think Kanye was managed by Roc Nation, but he tweeted that it's not managed by them anymore.
Shock.
Big Sean's managed by Roc Nation. Yeah. A lot of them are like signed today, whatever, but managed by Roc Nation.
Well, honestly, you can tell that Jay's had a big influence on him. It's like, he seems mature. It's the way he moves.
Yo, I miss this Rick Ross story, you know. This Rick Ross. Yeah.
It's still there, man. It's still there.
Nah, it's losing weight, man. It's not the same, man. you can't talk like this when you're in shape, you know.
The heavy breathing's fake.
Yeah.
But yeah, man. I'm happy to meet, man. I'm happy he's back, and I'm happy.
But even
that...
when it was,
you know what, as well, the thing that I saw a clip of it for his interview with the Daftrey came out. He says, yo, at the end of the day, yeah, I'm out, but there's so many of the black men that are in the same situation.
See, that's what I wanted to ask. Like, the whole judicial side of it, I feel like knowing you, you're going to deep it. So
like, yo,
I want you...
At the end of the day, say, yes, please don't say
that. I stopped myself that time.
Thank you. I'm glad you stopped saying that.
That would have been a super pause. Yeah, give the people the deep dive, yeah.
Why are you even saying... Yeah, pause.
No, you can't pause that. The people...
Yo,
give the listeners a deep dive in it.
I'm not deep diving into nothing.
You can't pause that.
Yeah. I ain't deep diving nothing.
Get your mind out the gutter, man.
Anyway.
I've never really thought about it on that side, so let me hear what...
It's in terms of the judicial system, I think that the way that... Because he's a celebrity, people will sit there and say, yo, he only got out because he's rich. He got out because he's a rapper. He got out because he has this, that connection. My cousin, Day Day, who had a friend that he got locked up. He's still in prison. Now, the fact is that Meek had a case. If a person ain't got a case, you ain't going to do nothing. Yeah? If there's video evidence of him shooting up the bank and stealing the money, and he goes like this into the camera and runs off, he ain't got a case. The fact is, obviously, there is thousands and hundreds of thousands of black men that shouldn't fully be in for the time they're in, or shouldn't be in full stop. Now, it's a case of what now? How is the judicial system in America going to reevaluate all of those cases? Because the fact is, you've got to say to the court, say, look, man,
they're not got it.
We've got a case to say he shouldn't be there.
Mm.
You get me? We've got this, 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 and this. And then either the court can say, I am cool, we'll take it seriously, let's hear what you got to say. Or they'll just throw it out. Now, in terms of, like, you know, them wasting the court time, it's like, yo, a lot of them will be thrown out.
I mean, all I can see is happening the same. It's the judge and the person that initially arrested Meek, isn't it?
Yeah.
I feel like the lawyers can pull up and say, oh, well, that judge... was corrupt in the Meek case, or maybe officer that arrested. Other than that, there's not really an angle that you can come through.
If you ain't got a case, you can't do it. But
yeah.
if you've got family there and you think you've got a case, yo, you should try, man. Because at the end of the day, it's your family, and you're gonna try for your family as well, regardless. Just obviously, if the man just went and just like sprayed up a room full of people and just like walked out and is trying to say he's innocent and there's video evidence, you ain't gonna work. But you know what I mean.
Yeah, I want to see a Meek Mill interview.
Yeah, that'd be good. That'd be good, man. That'd be good. I want to watch the one that was the day after he came out.
Oh, he's done one.
Yeah, he's done one.
Maybe.
What is it? Something? Is it Dateline?
Did you see what
Dateline.
Oh, one of those news one ones. Like, news okay, ones, yeah, I know. Ones, man.
I mean.
All right, cool. Let's move on to the did you see? Boom, 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 boom. All right, yo. I'm gonna say the same thing I say every week. I don't say nothing.
But oh, this, what is wrong
no,
with
but
you?
this week. I've been busy up until Thursday evening. I wasn't too busy again. And then Avengers came out, and
I've been trying to just stay social media.
Oh, yeah, exactly. I ain't touching social media.
I'm watching it tomorrow, so nobody ruin it.
Yeah, same
if you do,
tomorrow.
I'm not joking, yeah. This is the one time if someone ruins this film for me, yeah, I'll box them.
No, I'm hunting you down.
I will box them. Get me.
But yeah, man. But what I did want you to tell me more about, like I said, when it comes to the news and that, I don't really take it in, but this whole Windrush thing,
okay,
and Spock,
okay, so basically
because I don't really know. I've seen David Dammy and the big speech.
You know
I
what's
really,
going on?
No,
okay, so basically
well, sorry, yeah, I know vaguely what's going
okay,
on.
Okay, so
yeah.
Basically
give them the deep vibe, deep dive.
Can you stop saying that? Pause, please.
Anyway, I didn't say me, don't give me the deep dive.
Now, shut up. Just stop. You get me? You're just trying to make it worse.
Get the people down.
Shut up. So, basically, before I was rudely interrupted, obviously, Jamaica's part of the English Commonwealth.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah? Seems like we were taken there as slaves. Mm. All relates back to slavery. But, basically, some people, when they came over here to England, yeah, because they were offered jobs and blah, 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 they didn't have their passport papers written up, yeah? But they said, nah, it's all right, it's cool.
Yeah.
You can come in, everything's sorted, it's all nice. Now, fast forward that to, I think they tried to do it in 2014, but they were unsuccessful. But fast forward that 4 more years, 2018. Now I don't want to start. Well, I think they've started deporting people.
Yeah. Yeah. So what's the start of it? Like what? Why? Like why is it just
no immigrants?
No immigrants. They're trying to power it off now as immigration. When really the fact is that if this person this is my point.
Yeah.
This is my point. This person has paid tax.
Yeah.
This person has worked. In this country, they pay tax to the government, to the Queen. So what's your beef? What's your beef? If they're giving you money, yeah? I know gypsies, yeah? Or travellers, whatever. The nice people, yeah, to me. They ain't paying no tax.
The gypsies are cool, innit? Just loud,
cool.
Innit?
They're just loud.
Shout
and just don't fight none of them.
Mm.
Just don't fight. Yo. Yo, if you're from ends that ain't got, like, you know, gypsies or travellers, whatever, yo, don't fight them, man. You fight one, yeah. Yo, crew's coming. Squad! And they're coming hella quick. Yo, hella quick, you know, fam. But anyway, they're not paying taxes, yeah, because they may say, well, I haven't got a full proper address, so you can't write nothing to me. You can't pin me down because I keep moving in it.
Yeah.
Now, if I've got an address, if I've got a national insurance number, this is the thing, I've got a national insurance number. I've got a national insurance number. I've got an address. I've got, you know, everything else. I'm paying tax. And then all of a sudden you say, oh, no. You can't now.
So wait, so...
We've changed the rules. Sorry, Leroy. Our bad, you know. You can't work here no more. You're going to have to go back to Jamaica.
But wait, yeah.
And then you say, yo, but all my family's in England. Sorry, Leroy, that's just out of my control. But here's your flight and you've got to go because if you don't, you know, you're an illegal immigrant.
But yeah, so wait.
And yeah, there was I've heard of children of them getting deported as well.
What, with the parents or just children?
I think the parents had gone back to Jamaica and they deported the child.
Mm.
I don't know how that's worked.
Well, yeah, because if you're born here, you're a British citizen, isn't it?
That's what I'm saying. And some of them have been deported.
Okay, so wait, hold up. So is it illegal immigrants, basically? If you don't have the papers, technically you're
in it. I'm trying to say.
But then if you're an illegal immigrant, how are you paying tax?
How are you paying tax?
Yeah, so if you're paying tax and you've been working and you're on...
Exactly.
How can you do one and be illegal?
Exactly.
So...
Like, little pagan, Ashley Wood, I think her name is, little pagan. Trying to come with some excuses, come about... Because basically, yeah, last week they said, oh, the files were destroyed. And then, all of a sudden, by magic, Harry Potter must have walked in the file room. Here they are. Wow, what a surprise. They turned up out of nowhere. Come on, behave.
Who's what, like the people's house?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, this doesn't even make sense.
Exactly.
It don't make no sense at all.
This is what I'm saying. This is why so many people are getting vexed. Because it's like, yo, what are you talking?
Because I thought, literally, I seen David Lammy said all that. Sounded good, and then my woman was like, "Are we gonna have another look into it?" And I ain't gonna lie, I thought that was the end of it. I mm-hmm. thought they solved it, and she looked into it, and yeah, anyone born, anyone in the country before 1972, or whatever the date is, in the call. I just thought, yeah, bless, yeah, sorted. I didn't know it was still an issue, but it just doesn't make sense. How can you do that?
They're just pagans.
But how can you do that? How are they getting away with it?
Are they getting away with that? Make the rules, fam.
But that doesn't make sense. Okay, but.
Okay, let me just say something. Okay, let me just say something. Yeah. You see the law we abide by.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is the law right or wrong?
The law.
The law.
I'd have to say it's flawed.
Thank you. Because the thing is, the law is only applicable. Mm-hmm. Yeah. From the person who's making it, what they deem as right.
Well, I thought that.
Think about
I
this.
I thought it was the Think judge. About this. I thought the judge.
Not even the judge, fam.
So the judge can
was
be over.
Slavery right?
No.
But it was lawful to have slaves.
Yeah, yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So the idea of people saying, "Oh, that's against the law don't mean nothing, you know." In a law, if the law said to you, "Okay, then cool, your name's Daniel. So basically, we're gonna chop off your left foot." Because that's the new law. It's a new law that's coming.
No, but then I always, not to sound naive, but I always kind of felt like a law is...
good for all the people.
No, not even that. A law is just made of common sense, like of things that makes A and B, you know what I mean? One and one equals two, like law is meant to make sense.
It's not.
If you pay taxes for the country, you're a citizen.
Mm-mm.
You know what I mean? Like, how are you...
How? I only make it applicable to the person that makes it.
Yeah, I mean, I don't really know
don't
anything about law.
I mean, at the end of the day, how can you? Last year, one politician, he made a law so that when you bought, I think it was your sixth house, you don't have to pay a certain tax on it.
Yeah.
The year after, he bought six houses. And then on the seventh one, he didn't have to pay no tax.
Yeah.
How coincidental? You see what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying?
Money, innit?
And this is my point. They make it applicable to them.
Mm.
And this is the problem. People are sitting there saying, oh, yeah, but it's wrong. It's not a point of right or wrong. It's what they're going to do.
Okay, but I don't know, but are there many black politicians? We need more black politicians. We need someone to make a law.
Probably
if a politician can make a law about his seven houses.
I know there's bear kids that do want to do politics,
yeah.
But they just don't get nowhere because... The ceiling's there, man. It's like, nah, you're gonna get through.
Gotta keep trying, man. Someone's gonna break the ceiling.
Yes,
someone's
but that is the one. They will let the token in.
Nah, not the token. Someone's gonna smash the ceiling and bring
How
everyone through.
Smash the ceiling.
Smash it in
they
glass.
They can't smash the ceiling because they're not in power.
But you gotta get the one token that they let through should be bringing everyone
the
in.
The one token's gotta play by the rules because if you're the one token, if you don't play by the rules, they'll turn you into an MLK and you gotta die for what you believe in.
Yeah, but you can die. You can be a martyr, die, and let. you can die and bring change on the back of your death.
Because the fact is you're dead.
People bring change on the back of their death. Martin Luther King died and some civil rights act was in place afterwards.
Like, yeah, but the fact is, yeah, since MLK and Malcolm X, how many new people have come to that strength to unite the people?
Well, how many people have come up or how many people have
how
tried?
Many people to stand in
how many people have tried?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's a different...
Exactly.
That's different.
You know what I mean? It's hard, man.
But I'm sure people have tried.
People would have tried, but the ceiling's there.
I've got to keep trying.
Ceiling's there, man.
I've got to keep striving.
I'm not saying give up, by the way. I'm not saying give up because, yo, you got to keep trying and fighting for it because we need more people like that.
We're a bit pushed for time.
I know.
You got any more digicies or...
Where is it? I was just looking at it as well. Where is he? Oh, yeah. I was going to ask a quick question. What did you see? So, my mate Donnie T.
I don't know. Trump. Oh, Donald Trump. That's your mate?
Yeah, he's mate. There's a lot of bants. Just bants. That's what he's, you know. He's Twitter.
He's banter. You know, he's a joke,
yeah. Banter. And it's annoying that people take it 100% seriously. And yo, he's just winding you up.
And he puts stuff in brackets, like, yeah. Lowest black unemployment in years.
Yeah,
it's like,
yeah, this is what I'm going to talk about. And the thing is, you know what? It's like when he tweeted about Kanye saying real cool.
Yeah.
A cool guy. It's like when he said, when I heard it and I read it, I could imagine him smiling and going,
yeah.
I was like, you're an ignorant git, you know, you're an idiot. You're an idiot, you know. But I laughed because I was like, yo, you're so annoying, but you're funny. Mm. But anyway, so Kanye says, Kanye West has performed a great service to the black community. Big things are happening and eyes are being opened for the first time in decades. Legacy stuff. Thank you also to Chance and Dr. Daryl Scott. They really get it. Lowest black and Hispanic employer in history. Yo. What is it, like, chances? Is Chance hurting himself by what is his career, by what he's, like, coming out with?
Nah.
Or is he not really aiming for that audience?
Did you see his statement afterwards? Like,
I didn't see his whole statement after.
Yeah, because he only really tweeted that. He tweeted out, black people don't have to be Democrats, by the way.
Yeah, I get that.
And... I didn't see anything wrong with it.
I didn't see nothing wrong with it because, yeah, it's fair.
But obviously, everyone got angry.
But I'm just on about like the rest of the people, they'll kick off.
Well, yeah, so everyone got angry. And then he did put out a statement, basically simplifying the statement. He said he still believes that, but the timing was wrong. And he understands that the timing was wrong because at the time, that wasn't the conversation. He wasn't talking about black people don't have to be Democrats.
Mm.
The timing was off. So basically, he did apologize. But, nah, I don't think Chance is carries himself well enough to get out of stuff like that. Like, that won't hurt him.
You'd hope so.
Mm.
Hope so. But yeah. By that, what was the other? Did you say?
Yeah, timing.
I know as time's going. You want to just how many tracks? You want to do playlist?
Yeah.
How many tracks?
Three tracks.
Three.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm only playing short clips, but you know what? This song ain't even that good, yeah. Hard for you to play this time. This song ain't even that good, but I just stumbled upon it, and I really like the snare drums in it, and it's quite repetitive.
So you don't like the tune, you just like the snare?
No. I like the song for 2 minutes, but it's like a 4-minute song, and let me just play the tune. It's called Ballerina, and it's by Belly.
Okay.
But yeah, and it's like, for someone, Belly's talented. Belly's quite good, but I've noticed even on that Maintain tune and this one, this is 2016, but he likes to ride the same flow.
All the time.
And for a song like this,
could have done so much more.
Yeah, so for 2 minutes, I really like this song, but it's a 4 minute long song, and it's like, I know this flow now, you get me?
Yeah.
But like I said, the snare drum in this tune and the bass drum, all the drums are heavy in this tune still. This tune, everyone should know this tune.
Hold tight, Jay Horse, man. He lost his father today, you know.
Swear down.
Yeah, man. Hold tight, him, man.
Yeah, man.
Prayers and thoughts to his family, man. It's hard.
Like this
man.
One, I didn't even say
that. Yeah, enough love, man. Respect, man.
Yeah.
It's hard, man.
And you know what? This tune, yeah. Like, I feel good when I hear this song, you know. I don't know what it is, but I just feel good.
You know what,
that bar touches me, you know. I had a good night's sleep since God knows when, for real. What do you say? You imagine what?
It came out like about this time last year, yeah.
Yeah.
Yo, the whole Body Power like weekend last year.
Yeah.
This whole album was banging. I was like, sun was blazing. It's like, yeah. Yo, feeling it.
This album, yeah.
Hard, you know?
I know people don't sleep on it, but this album needs to get proper like props. Like, this album is so good for a UK album, and I don't even want to say it now.
No,
yeah.
It's for an album period.
Eh?
Just for an album period.
No, well, yeah, but I don't want to say it now because it's gonna sound like I'm really slating the person, but like, if you compare, I listened to like 90s album in it, and 90s so sick, but like as an album, it's a bit samey, you get me? And it's like Jay Huss's album in comparison, I just feel like he did everything in one album and it was very cohesive. The 90s album is good. I still prefer One For Out, the last release. I feel like that was better, but 90s album is big as well. My third tune is called Go and Big Up Yourself by Roy Woods.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think I got Roy Woods, you know.
Roy Woods have got some tunes still, but I think most of his tunes ain't too great. But you know, go out there and listen to Roy Woods yourself and make up your own mind. Sign to OVO Sweatshirt. Sound. Yeah, man. Yeah, I bought some shoes today, you know. I don't know why I just said that. But really, really happy with myself.
Did you see Kevin's heart video?
Yes. Yeah. I don't know why I like it so much, but I like it a lot.
But you know what? Looking at that video, I sat there and I thought, you know what? J. Cole's, like, obviously good, but Kevin Hart's a genius, you know.
Yeah.
Teflon done.
Yeah.
Because people are going to look at that video and say, I don't hate Kevin Hart anymore.
I want to know. I really want to know what his wife thinks about how he's going about this, you know. Man's called the tour irresponsible and all that now. I just want to know. But at the same time, I didn't even say J. Cole's album. I think I've realised what it is, why, when it comes to replay value. His beats are really dull.
He wants to hear the words.
Well, yeah, because I spoke to Apostle yesterday, and I said, "Oh, because he said he's still bumping it," and
yeah, I was like,
but don't you feel like as a music man, don't you feel like the beats are really dull? And he's like, but Apostle was like, "Yeah, but it gives you so much space to listen to what he's saying."
Yeah,
and I was like, "Yeah, that's true still." And I felt like with me, I'm a very beats. Like, I love beats. I'm driven by the beats.
You know me, I'm lyrical.
Yeah. So I said that's probably why J. Cole doesn't connect with me, because it's all about the beat. Not to say all about the beat, but I hear the beat first.
But yeah, my first playlist.
I'll take Apostle as well.
Is J. Cole.
Yeah.
Brackets.
That's already on the playlist, you know. Well, yeah.
Is it on there?
I put that on for last week still.
You put it on there last week? When did you put that on there?
Because you know what I do? I always put, obviously, the three songs that we put on.
And then it just has to throw in ones that he wants to put on it.
No, ones related to what we were talking about in the week, innit? So.
Okay, I'll swap it then.
I'll put Brackets on and put Erykah Badu on and on. And I put another tune on there.
All right, then, cool. In that case, I will add Bachelor in...
Card done. Oh, yeah. Is it recording? Oh, hey. Oh, yeah, I'll put ATM on there as well.
You put it on there? What is wrong with you?
That's all it was.
You didn't put on the bracket, did you?
ATM brackets and Erykah Badu. ATM brackets and on.
This guy, man, he's just something else. Why is he like this?
Why is it like this? Yeah, I like this one. Okay.
Oh, what's this called?
Friends.
Yeah.
You ain't put this on yet, have you?
This is, huh? No, this ain't on, this is hard, you know.
It's hard.
This is hard.
I like it, man. I've been banging this tune all week. I've been banging a whole album. So people just need to enjoy, man. Sit back, enjoy. If you want to light up a blunt, do that. Or drink more water like me.
Yes. Now that Kill Edward guy. It's sick, innit?
You're an idiot, you know.
Nah, but I like the Kill Edward persona though, still. Because Kill Edward is like, he's when he succumbs to the to the evils, basically, innit?
The evils. Jeez, that's some old school that is. The evils. Old people know what I'm talking about.
Hey, man. The evils. D apostrophe.
I was kind of tired this morning. So I needed this song to, like, you know, give me a little strength and a little power. And people are probably thinking, yo, Adrian, you don't like him anyway. But I do like him, but he was just intent. So I'm going to play some Bruno Mars. Finesse.
What?
I should spit Hot 16.
Drop top Porsche.
Okay, it's gone. It's back. Hey. Okay, it's gone. Yeah, now, my last track is, you know what? You know when you hear a tune and you just smile and you think, yo, you've got one, you know, fam. I don't know if you saw my Instagram. Yeah. I was listening to The Godfather 2.
Yo,
I'm not going to lie, yeah.
Hey, listen, Wiley, you know.
Behave.
Godfather 1, I've said it multiple times. Yo. Godfather 1 is sick. I can't wait to listen to Godfather 2. Cannot wait.
Back-to-back tunes, you know, fam.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
Back-to-back tunes. Wiley's not playing. Queen held him up. Get me?
Oh, yeah.
Come back with a fire.
OBE, Wiley.
And this tune, yeah, I'm not lying. This track sounds like a single smash for the summer because it has radio play. Man, them will still get to it.
It's one with Shaka?
No.
Okay.
And this tune, I'm not going to, like, yo, trust me. I heard this and I was like, yo, they can play this song. They will be able to play this song on the radio in the daytime and people will bang it. When the sun's out blazing, yeah? Just listen. It's called Crash.
Big tune. She was looking peng. She was looking peng. I was on the ends with my friends, but I stepped into the zone she was in. She asked me what I do, I said, all I do is win. I really want to show you, like, everywhere I've been, because life is a journey, must travel well. And I get the feeling you're a must travel girl. Fireworks spark when I look into your eyes. You can see the fire when you're looking into mine. Yeah.
You don't know what you started. Cupid's taking shots at me. Was never meant to be the target. Just one hit and you got me. Who would have thought you made my body talk? Give me the fire I want, hotter than gold in the sun. Boy, you dangerous. Oh yeah, yeah. You're so dangerous. Oh,
Godfather 2 is out. Yo, it's hard, man. Came out on Thursday. It was Thursday.
I know that voice.
This is going to wind him up now.
Sinead Harnett.
Okay, just. But anyway.
Sinead Harnett.
Okay.
It is?
No one's questioning this guy. Sinead Harnett, is it you?
Have you seen her?
No. But yeah, that was my last pick for the Warriors.
What was your first one again? Sorry.
It's a J. Cole one, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, my bad, my bad. All right, cool.
Yo, fam, come on, man. We playing that?
Yo, it's I'm getting hungry again, innit? So
what time it is? You must want to... It's not working. No. No. Oh, I know. I just want to drop the...
Wow!
You got one there.
You thought we forgot! Rapid fire.
He downloaded that out, yeah?
Yeah, rags. Yo.
Yeah, we're not waiting for those still.
All the people out there, yeah, you know, sitting in the car quiet, thinking they play the Hard Food playlist, and not listening. Well, guess what? Come for y'all!
I'm loving it, man.
Yo. Right, I'm done now, yeah. I'll take it off. Is the Ox up? Hey, why'd you just go show off?
So you're telling me he had all these sound effects, yeah?
You get me? Spock had all these sound effects.
Isn't it?
Just ignoring us.
Wait until episode 29, you know? But yeah, yeah. That's it, man. That's it. It's time to wrap up. Let me play this one.
Next week, yeah.
To wrap up.
I'm gonna give my review on Infinity Wars and Juice.
Oh yeah.
Just know.
And yeah. Let's take away. What can we take away? What do we say about Kanye then? Kanye, hopefully. The music's good, and hopefully we get an interview, and hopefully we find out
up a few things,
what his head's on.
But to be fair, I'm just like, yo, for me, I'm like, yo, he's just another human being. Your opinion don't change, not for me now.
Meat Mill's, you agree? Meat Mill's home, looking forward to music, and looking forward to an interview from him as well.
Positivity and progress in Meat Mill.
Yeah,
staff the bike, staff everything, just be progressive and be powerful, man.
Yeah.
I mean, blessings to Meat Mill.
J. Cole's album.
Big up, the kids need it.
Still sounds good, but yeah.
I love it, man. The kids need it, but the kids won't listen to it, so the adults have to teach them, man.
The beats aren't designed to grab the kids.
Doesn't matter.
You get me?
Because the beats that are made to grab the kids, they don't listen to the words.
Nah, but I think that's what he tried to do, innit? He tried to make... He tried.
But it's not, you're not going to.
Yeah.
It's like, if you ask how many kids who sit down, it's like, okay, what are the words to mask off?
Mask off.
No.
That's the word.
What is the verse?
Fam, that song is the most repetitive song for me ever. Did you like that song, Mask Off?
It's just a club tune.
It's just Mask Off. Mask Off. Like, what? Oh, it says that. Yeah, club anyway, tune. I ain't even going to get started on that still. But yeah, and what else can we take away? Bun the government, basically. Our episode just be like, yo.
Yeah, man, bun them.
But yeah, man, time to sign off. Hope everyone has a great week.
Yes.
See you again, same time next week.
Follow us. You know where to follow us.
Yeah, man.
Hard Food Podcast.
Everywhere.
Our own social media platform. So, you know, show us love.
Mm-hmm.
Big up for the subscribers on YouTube. Big up for the followers. Big up for the people.
And the commenters. Keep commenting.
You know what? What's
feedback.
Mad? I don't realise how many people actually listen to whole episodes. And you know what? I appreciate it like mad. I appreciate it like big.
Yeah, man.
Big respect to all of you people who are listening.
Big love.
Everybody that watches it. Every single person that watches it. Big respect. Can't express it enough, man. It's enough love and ting.
Big up, man. Big up. And on that note... See you guys next week, innit?
Yeah!
Peace!
What a...
Bless up.
Yeah.